The winter can bring heavy snow or even ice storms, which could cause power outages, and that could leave your family without heat until the electricity is restored. This video is going to show you how to safely heat your home if you do have to rely on alternative sources. So great, the lights just went out, and now it's starting to get cold. What do you do?
If the phone works, call your electric utility hotline to report the power outage. Only call 911 if you have a power line that is down.
Candles should not be used inside your house. There is too great a risk of fire.
Any generator must be carried outside to use. Be careful not to overload it with too many appliances, and make sure the extension cords are sized to carry the load. Plug in only what is absolutely needed. Never plug it into your house's electric circuit. That will cause a serious safety hazard, not only for you, but also for utility workers repairing the lines. Propane camping lanterns should not be used inside. Your next need is heat. Even without power, you still have options with fireplaces, wood stoves, and kerosene heaters. When using portable heaters, be careful. Keep them away from children and anything flammable. Be sure to open a window to provide ventilation. Take the heater outside to refill the tank. Use the right fuel, and never refill when the heater is in use or still hot. In an emergency, fireplaces can be a source of heat, although most of the heat goes up the chimney. If smoke comes into the room, open a nearby window to improve the necessary draft. Adding glass doors can prevent an uncomfortable draft in the room, and the fire will burn hotter. Remember to burn only wood and not paper, and never charcoal. If your fireplace doesn't have glass doors, be sure to use the metal screen to keep hot cinders and sparks from coming into the room. Keep children away from hot surfaces by using a sturdy metal fencing system that they can't push over. It is a really bad idea to try and use your kitchen stove or oven to try and heat your home because of safety and air quality risks. How do you cook meals? Although propane or gas camp stoves are very useful in an emergency, only use them outdoors due to extreme fire hazard and toxic fumes. Never ever use a charcoal grill inside your house or garage.
So what steps can you take at home to prepare for a power emergency?
Before winter, make sure the flues and chimneys of fireplaces and vented heaters are cleaned and inspected. Not all municipalities allow unvented kerosene heaters, so check before buying one.
Be sure to have plenty of flashlights available, and don't forget your extra batteries. Plus, you really should have a battery-powered radio at your home as well.
Make sure you have 3 days' worth of water and non-perishable food for family members and pets. There should be smoke alarms on every level of the home as well as near every bedroom. Test them monthly and replace the batteries at least once a year. Finally, install a carbon monoxide alarm and follow the instructions for placement.
We hope that you never have to experience a power outage, especially in the wintertime, but if you do, follow these guidelines and stay safe. I'm Denise McCracken with the PUC, and we're here to help.